Hey, 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 beautiful people, beautiful people. I am Elda. Listen, I trust and pray that you are having a blessed and prosperous day, whatever time it is when you are tuned into this video. Listen to me and hear me good. I just want to encourage somebody today, okay? I just want to encourage somebody today because, listen, I want to share with you this word that I heard so loud in my spirit this afternoon, and I had to allow myself to sit and let it marinate and receive what I had to take from it. You hear me? So what I'm about to say, I'm going to allow the Holy Ghost to speak through me, but some may receive it, some may not, okay? But I pray that it reach who it need to reach. I pray that it minister to whom it needs to be ministered unto, all right? But listen, I need you to listen to me, and I need you to hear me good, all right? And I want you to repeat after me. I shall not forfeit my blessing. Y'all, when I heard this word, I said it fell in my spirit like just suddenly. You do not forfeit your blessing. I shall not forfeit my blessing. I shall not forfeit my blessing. Okay, when you look at what forfeit means, when we look at Webster, it says to lose or to lose the right to, especially by some error, offense, or crime. Let me tell you something. You shall not forfeit your blessing. I shall not forfeit my blessing. Why? Because everything that is going on around you right now is chaotic. As I speak, as I'm talking to you right now, everything is chaotic. Then you feel like there's no sense of order. You feel like everything is just drying up and you just trying to keep your head above water. But you know deep down inside that you're drowning and you're trying to make sense of what's going on. Everything you try to do is not coming into fruition. Everything you're trying to do is not manifesting. You just feel like you at a dead end. No matter which route you go, you just feel like you're at a dead end. You're at a dead end. You're at a dead end. You know, this door is not opening. This door is closing. This person is not coming through. This person is cutting you off. And you're just at a place where you just really like, okay, God, what's going on? You know, when you find yourself at that place where everything is just going so chaotic, you just start to repent. Listen to me and hear me good. You start to repent like, Lord, you know, you repenting about everything. Listen to me and hear me good. Everything is happening for a reason, all right? And it has pushed you to a place where you want to forfeit. It is pushing you to a place where you want to give up. It is pushing you to a place where you are starting to doubt. It is pushing you to a place where you're tired. It is pushing you to a place where you are weary. But I am here to tell you on today, listen, you shall not forfeit your blessing. You will hear me say this time and time again. Listen, the word of God states, listen, do not weary in well doing, for you shall reap if you faint not. You shall reap if you faint not. So listen to me and hear me good. I know that you are tired. I know that you want to give up. I know the things are drying up. I know you are at a place where, like, God, I need you to come through like now. Not now, but right now. Because you're like, God, I am just trying to be obedient unto you. I'm just wanting to be obedient unto you. And it's like every time I come to this place of obedience, God, it's just like, oh, hell, just begin to break through. All hell just break loose up in my life, and I'm like, God, where are you, God? But I'm here to tell you, listen, you shall not forfeit, because baby, when I say that, you are so close. When I say you are so close to that breakthrough, when I say that you are so close to that deliverance, when I say you are so close to that increase, when I say you are so close to that elevation, when I say you are so close to that restoration, when I say that you are so close to that restitution, baby, you are almost there. And the enemy is doing doing every and anything to get you to a place where you forfeit. But I am here to speak strength unto you. I am here to speak stamina unto you. I am here to speak endurance unto you. I am here to release a fresh wind upon you. And listen, in the name of Jesus, I command the heavens to open up and anoint you afresh, because you shall not forfeit. You shall not give up. Listen, I know you tired, baby. I am too. I know you are. I know you weary. I know you weak. I know you trying to figure it out. But listen, it is beyond our control. It is beyond our control. You have to understand that everything that you are going through right now is only to awaken every dormant gift, every dormant talent. It is here to awaken you like never before. You have to understand you are preparing yourself. God is preparing you to take you into new realms and dimensions, so you cannot operate the way that you were operating before. You cannot go about things the way that you were going before. So it requires you to be obedient on another level, on another plateau. It is stretching you. Though we may not like it, though it is uncomfortable, I am here to tell you that God is a man. God is not man. God, and neither is he the son of man, shall he repent. Listen, he honor his words. He honor his word above his name. So I need you to come to a place where you command your emotions, where you command your mind back into alignment. You got to be real. Listen, you gonna break down, baby. You gonna cry, baby. But listen, don't stay there. I need you to get up. I need you to bounce up. I need you to mount up, because it says they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up like eagles. They shall mount up. They shall mount up. So I need you to hold on, baby, because when I say you so close, you so close, you so close, you so close. And listen, if I and the situation has pushed you to a place where you feel like these dry bones in the valley, I'm here to say that I'm your sister, as your sister on tonight, as your Ezekiel on tonight, that these dry bones, they shall live, they shall live, they shall live. But you had to come. You had to come to a place of death so that there can be a resurrection, baby, because you so close. But I need you to hold on. I need you to hold on. I need you to hold on. I need you to call on the might of Jesus. I need you to call on the angels. I need you to listen. I need you to come back to that place where you pray, where you fast, where you speak, and where you believe. All right. I need you to hide yourself in God and listen. Because that manifestation, that restoration, that breakthrough, that deliverance, all of that, what God has ordained, what God has orchestrated is coming. It's coming into fruition. It's coming into fruition. Even though that everything around us contradict what God is saying, even though everything around us contradict what God is showing us, listen, behold, he does a new thing. And he does not lie, y'all. God does not lie. God does not lie. But I pray, I release strength upon you. I release stamina upon you. I release endurance upon you now in the name of Jesus. Listen, I pray that you have been encouraged, and I pray that this has ministered to you. But I need you to rock with your girl and let me know that this word has hit you, that this word has awakened you, that this word has encouraged you, has motivated you, has pushed you. All right. And it was on time word. I need you to comment and say, I shall not forfeit my blessing. Comment, I shall not forfeit my blessing. But I love you. Be blessed, be encouraged, and remember, at the end of the day, baby, you have victory on every side.